Hey guys, your boy Compares, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Braga Chroma, where the last one left off, I should be saying I won the league, but I couldn't upload that video. I still have it, it's still on my hard drive, but the goddamn YouTube wouldn't let me upload it. I'm just gonna say it right now, I did win the league. And I got through in the Europa League. In fact, my games in this episode are my next round matches against Ajax. What were the results? In the first leg against Athletic Bilbao, I beat them 4-0, securing my place in the next round. Despite losing when I simmed the second leg, they couldn't beat me by enough goals. Then, in between those two legs, I beat Sporting 2-0 to put one foot on the pedestal for first place. And then I beat Benfica 4-0. And thanks to a 1-1 draw between Sporting and Porto, I won the league. Effort. Official confirmation, there's CD. Oh, it's not there. Well, that sucks. I'll just show you the league table. Well, hang on a second. Up. There's the league table. As you can see, you can do the math yourself. I'm miles ahead of Porto, they cannot catch me. Now it's a 3-horse race for second place between Porto, Sporting, and Benfica. Porto have the edge, but it's only 1 point between them and Sporting. But now I don't have to worry about them. I don't have to care what they do. I did also have a league game that I simmed against Real Madrid, who I won it 1-0, and Traore got the goal. And I looked it up to see when was the last time Braga won the Portuguese league. They've never won it. Apparently, I've made Braga history. They've never won the league. So, you're welcome, Braga. I've made Braga history. So, now I know for sure that I'm the first person to ever win the Portuguese league with all four major Portuguese teams being Porto, O Sporting, Benfica, and Braga. I know I'm the only one, because they've never won the league before now. That's a weird wait, I'm gonna be able to look. Now I know that they haven't won the league, so I'll take it. A lot of excitement already in the anyway, let's focus on Ajax here at the Amsterdam Arena.
Attractive attacking teams, and we'd expect that to be the case out here. Plenty at stake.
The match today is Ajax will play Braga.
Huge ass stadium.
Line up like this. Well, they're going to go with 4-3-3 here.
I'm looking forward to playing here for my next
Dutch system down the years.
Career mode when I play Ajax.
Bit of pressure.
I actually said that facing Ajax was a bit of a nice little teaser for my next career mode, because my next secondary career mode is with Feyenoord. So I'll be able to play the Ajax. I'll at least come up against them twice, if not more than that, the cup.
And it's going to be a goal kick.
But yeah. Amsterdam Arena, look at that.
You can hit a football, you can
burst the net. It's just one of those stadiums. I feel it doesn't get as much, you know, attention as it should. It's a very nice stadium. It's one of those stadiums I would love to visit in real life. I've often said, if Liverpool ever play Ajax, I want to go to that match. So, if Liverpool are in the Champions League next season, I know Ajax will be. If Liverpool can get past Sevilla and get into the Champions League next season, I hope we get paired off against Ajax. I don't know how I'll do it, but I'll make sure I can go and see that match. It's one of the main stadiums I'd love to see, along with the Amsterdam Arena, and of course. No wait, this is the Amsterdam Arena, I mean the Allianz Arena, which is a Bayern Munich stadium. I'd love to see Liverpool playing at the Camp Nou. I have been to the Camp Nou before, but that was to watch Barcelona and Celta Vigo. Much rather see Barcelona play be my team. We get trashed, but still like to see it. Say I was there for that match. There's a lot of things that they're just so amazing. They're just something you have to, I feel like I have to experience at some point. So, if given the chance, I would love if Liverpool could come up against Ajax in next year's Champions League. If Liverpool were in it. That's a key factor. Liverpool have to get into it first, because Ajax will be in there. Anyway, let's get to focusing on the.
Well, he saw the guy could switch the play to.
Match Ajax are being very good defensively so far, and let me have a. Clear cut opportunity. De Jong avoids the challenge. Hansen wins a corner at least. Foley, yes, would you believe it? I don't know why he's grabbing the ball. He's grabbing the ball like we need another goal. Well, that is a fantastic away goal. Well, Silson, usually a very good keeper, or misjudged that, and it's 1-0 to me. And that is his first Europa League goal. And most of these guys. Well, actually, they played in the group stages.
As a foul, and it is a free kick. Two more minutes to play of added time.
Yes. Rodriguez over to Hansen. If he can get the turkey kick cross that in, and it doesn't go any. Sorry. Hansen, 2-0. Great link up play between the strike partners. A terrible defensive header. I was on it like a rash with Traore. Gives it to Hansen, and he gives Susan no chance, really. Maybe if the player had stayed on the line, you know, just a thing I noticed. I'll take it. It's 2-0. Fantastic. There are the other Europa League matches. Borussia Dortmund versus Juventus. Oh, and there's a Sporting. So I could come up against another Portuguese club at some point in the remainder of the competition if I get past Ajax.
Second half.
That's it. And if they get past, yeah, if they win their match. Still a long way to go. This is only halfway through the first leg. And I know I have a 2-goal lead. But 2-goal lead is never. To Tillemans. Oof. I worked my way into shooting here. Yeah, I managed to avoid hitting a man square in the fucking head. And the keeper made a great save. And plus, Bully. I couldn't. I pressed the shoot, but the defender cleared it before her bully got a chance to hit it.
First 45 minutes. It was a good goal from him. Good overall performance, actually.
Santos. Bully.
It's a decent
pass. Oof. He had so much room. Why did he header it at the keeper? Or header it in the opposite direction, genius.
It's a quick break. Shots on it.
Santos. Great save. Troy will make it a 3. He Chelsea will be delighted when they would be delighted if this happened in real life, if they sent Traore out and Lonnie scored. I think that's 32 goals in all competitions for Traore now. I could be wrong. I think he was on 30. Neves. Fender is lucky he missed that, because that he could have easily pumped that into his own net for 4-0.
Slip past his man now.
Tillemans. Hansen. 4-0 it is. Hang on a second. Sorry about that. The window must have been open because I could hear pretty outside. He's louder than it normally is. Anyway, 4-0, fantastic. I'm going to be playing the second leg regardless, but this will make it much easier. Oh, and Milik.
That's a poor touch in there.
He's one of Ajax's best young players. Gone off with an injury.
We're looking for that player to come back on, and he is coming back on.
Oh no, he's still on. I guess he ran it off.
He doesn't come off unless he is hurting, and clearly he felt he could carry on once he'd been able to run it off on the sideline. Fischer.
Tillemans. Kessé.
Able to make a good interception.
Couldn't find them, Neves.
That's very good defending. And the player had nowhere to go.
It's gone out for a throw. Santos. So he did take off Milik. Is he injured or is he? I guess they're not taking any precaution. Smart move there by the Ajax manager. You don't want to take any precautions, especially with a good player like Milik. Sorry, Milik. On the milk by accident. Nah, Traore has made it 5-0 in 6 goals.
Such a one-sided affair, but look at the scoreline. 1 extra minute before the whistle goes. Fischer. Final whistle.
Ajax, we're very good for about half an hour, but up till 40 minutes, and the 41st minute, everything went to quite literal shit. All the other games finished 1-1. Are you serious? Dortmund and Juventus 1-1. Schalke and Fenerbahce 1-1. And Frick. And Sporting and game 1-1. Would you freaking believe it? He bruised his shoulder. Should be out for 5 days. He'll be back in time for the second leg. Well, draw, I'll take it. I don't have to worry about results anymore. I've won the league. And no one important got injured. And the only injury is a one-day injury. Which, again, why am I even being told about that? Again, I'm the manager. I should know about that. But still, it feels kind of pointless helping people. Oh. He won't be able to play if there's a match, if there's a phantom match tomorrow. I'm like, our next match isn't for a number of days. And he won't be playing, so. Wait, did I see, oh god damn it, are you serious? Again? Are we seriously gonna be going through this again? Is this seriously happening again? Offer new contract. 3 years. Fucking doubling in wages. I'm sick of this. It's rumored bullshit. This is the second time this year. Sorry, second time this season. Huh. They're away goal. Away goal? They have no away goal. They were home the first leg. Their away jersey is green as well. Huh. Interesting.
That's a
odd coincidence. See, told you Milik would be equipped for the second night.
This is the home team lineup. So, Alan, 4-4-2.
Yeah, I think it looks that way, Martin. Yes, it's the conventional shape. It's the one that the manager prefers.
Martin Atkinson, today's referee.
I don't want to embarrass them too much, so I'll just get 1-0 and I'll... It's not where I go to pass it.
Very well done with the inside of the head as well as the outside. Good pass.
Drury.
That's safely away.
Santos. Try it. 1-0. There we go. There's the goal. What I wanted to get. Just to say, I won on the night in both legs. Excuse me.
That's a wide margin, isn't it? 6-0.
Sorry if... Should I score more goals? I really don't like to pass it around. That's very disrespectful to Ajax. You know what? I'm gonna go for as many goals as possible. Passing around, even though I have them pretty well beat.
Lost possession here.
It would be disrespectful to
fastest man here.
And thank you, I'll take a penalty.
No question. If this goes in,
well, silly.
Down the office for those defenders, and yet another rush challenge.
Two man's from the spot. And I blew it wide.
Should be making the keeper work at least.
Oh, freaking course.
Stop the game for the free kick.
Another foul. It was Piano again. He must feel like he's getting bullied out there. That's twice in a row. He's been fouled.
Very weak.
Once for a free kick, once for the bound.
Fisher.
Great tackle by Tillemans. Never foul, I'll take that. At least this one was on Piano.
To the goalkeeper's hands, and not really challenged the keeper then. Nice move to get away from the defender. He's lost control. It's a bad pass. He's given it, trying his luck from a long way out, but the goalkeeper very comfortable in dealing with it. Good contest between these two as they jostle for possession.
Hey!
Goalkeeper's reached that shot.
Piano could have easily been judged to foul the Ajax man there, but and go a show away. Why not? Guess what all three is.
Now he's looking for some support.
Oh, skill. Oops. Almost left the pot on it. Ah, after all that, I lose the ball.
Well, with this two...
There's the halftime whistle. I like I'm going for more goals, but I haven't gotten. There's only one goal in the other games. And that's Atletico's scoring. So that's 2-1 to Anfield. As it is, the other two games are going to go to the away, or first leg away teams, that being Juventus and Fenerbahce, because they have the away goals. Scoring would need to score to at least send their game to the next I'll play a Tillman's parent club. Because I only signed him on. It is up. Oh, is that not a free kick ref?
I don't know why he was shooting from there, to be honest with you.
You say so. Well, that would have been a free kick. Apparently, no, it wasn't.
A good performance, isn't it, Alan, from him in the first half?
Well, he played really well.
Traore took his time but still scored. Two nil on the night, 7-0 on Saturday. Traore has 4 goals against Ajax.
Well, let's take another look at the goal. Widen the margin here to 2-0.
Volley. Rodriguez.
The cross coming in.
Hey.
That wasn't a very good decision to shoot from there.
Well, collective groans right around this stadium and some looks of disgust from teammates.
Santos.
Let's see what the ref's going to do. Spread it out wide.
Yeah.
Chance to get some width into this attack.
Go in.
It's really the way to get the ball.
Get back in. Sorry.
Very straightforward save from goalkeeper.
Couldn't get there before Citizen.
Well, you can see what he was trying to do, but the pass wasn't on. It was a
bad pass. Yeah, he did stand behind the keeper. Sorry. You about that?
Pretty easy to defend against. Well, he's got support here.
Turn around.
Fine cross.
Rodriguez.
Good block by the defender. Jabba.
Here's on.
Oh, it's a corner.
Corner?
We've got a substitution coming up, Alan, now, and it's the midfield player who's going off. And in that part of the pitch, they've been second best.
They have been.
Doesn't come to anything. Santos.
Oof.
I guess your man's thinking is anywhere but here. Oh, great tackle by Sewell. Traore.
But he's cleared it. 84 minutes gone, 6 minutes to go.
Paxton wins the ball back. I'm not sure what he's doing all the way back here, but I'll take it.
There goes the cross. They put that cross.
Ah! Screw you, Citizen. Hanson.
From the attacker, but he was made.
Wonderful save.
Traore.
Really
Hello, Nargo! No! Oh! Luck was not on his side on that occasion. We'll only get another chance. Oh, that was the golden opportunity to complete Torres hat trick, and I'm not gonna get another opportunity. But 2-0 on the wraps up a 7-0 win on aggregate. Troy being the star of the show. Fenerbahce, he beat Schalke 1-0 to knock them out. Anderlecht got a second goal that knocks out Sporting 3-1. And Juventus and Dortmund, there was no goal in the second leg, which means Juventus go through with their away goal from the first leg. Which, if I was Dortmund, I would feel hard done by that. There you go. I'm not Dortmund, I can't do anything like that. What I can do is sim ahead. See if it has. Yeah, there we go. Happy to stay. I knew you'd see it my way. I just had a crazy thought you'd see it my way. I don't know why. Let's see. I will be playing Anderlecht, so the final will be either against Fenerbahce or Juventus. And you just know. I just get this odd feeling it's going to be Juventus. I don't know why, but I just get the feeling it's going to be Juventus. Are you serious? Are you serious? That's bullshit! What the fuck is that? He's in between in this game and that game. It's a good thing I already have Benfica beaten from the first leg. It is a good thing. So you're gonna see the games against Anderlecht. Until then, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe for more videos very soon. Sorry that I couldn't get the video up on Saturday. I did record it. It's not my fault. Blame YouTube. Contact YouTube. Direct all your angry emails and comments and whatever you were planning to do. Direct those to YouTube because it's YouTube's fault, not mine. Until next time, thanks for watching. Until next time, I hope you all have a very